Hello and welcome to EQ International Magazine, India's oldest and leading solar media. And today we have Mr. Prashant Mathur with us from Satvik. A very warm welcome to EQ, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, can you just let us know about Satvik, like from when it is in the solar industry and what are your plans in 2021 and as well as 2022? What's the target for 2022 as well?
So in 2021, we have completed 6 years of module manufacturing. We are a 500 megawatt module manufacturing based out of Ambala. We are the largest in North India and amongst the top 7 in India. We are adding another 300 megawatt in Ambala, so we'll be 800 megawatt by November this year. And next year, our target is that we are adding another greenfield project is coming in Gujarat. Wherein we are adding 1.2 gigawatt, so we'll be 2,000 megawatt or 2 gigawatt module manufacturing company by March-April 2022.
If you talk about in numbers or roughly idea, like how much till now modules you have supplied till now in India itself?
Our total module supplied in India, I would say, is about a gigawatt. And this year also, We are running almost 100% of our manufacturing capacity. There has been a lot of policy changes during this time, and there's a lot of uncertainty also because of SGD and BCD issues. But we still feel that the market has a lot of demand, and if some of these challenges can be taken care of, we feel that it's going to be a very good year for us.
If you talk about technology, like any new technology Satvik has come up with this year or in the coming year we are coming up with?
Yes, even today at REI we have launched our new product, which is half-cut multi-bus bar technology, which is the latest cell module technology globally. We are doing 530, 540, 545 watt panels. The equipment has potential to go up to 610, 620 watts. So we have launched the product. We are going to start manufacturing full scale from November this year. So that is the latest technology. Apart from that, poly and mono, those are our bread and butter products till now, so that is also going on well.
So if you talk about the exports, so what are your plans for exports? Like, do you want to go for the international market or you are into the process?
Actually, our current lines are poly and mono, which while the world has moved towards half cut and multi bus bar, so our expansion which is coming from November will be multi bus bar, and our new facility which is coming in Gujarat is coming in Gandhidham, where we have taken a 52 acre project where we'll be doing cell module integrated. Apart from that, we also are going to do some lithium ion batteries and probably inverters. So all that is the reason why we are doing it in Gujarat, is because we want to cater to the export market, and we feel that it's quite closer to Kandla and Mundra, so where we'll be catering to global markets. There's a very huge demand for Indian modules in US and Europe and in other parts of Asia as well, Australia as well, and we want to tap into that markets. The problem which we have been facing till now, being in a place wherein the seaport is not there, is the freight cost and logistically, and also Indian market has been quite strong. So we have not really focused a lot till now on export market, though we have done some exports into Africa. But our new facility will be focusing very heavily on export as well. So we plan to do about 30-40% of our manufacturing to export markets.
That's great. Okay, if we talk about like the Indian solar market, so what are the challenges and what are the opportunities we get? And there are very international brands as well. who are collaborating with the Indian manufacturers. So how we see it, like, is it an opportunity beneficial for the Indian manufacturers?
Yeah, if you see in India the policies, you know, I've always said that if the government is not able to get policies well, at least leave the industry alone and let them figure out, because currently what has happened is there's too many policies up and down. So, you know, safeguard duty went away. Everybody was expecting that it will continue until BCD comes in, because the market was heavily, you know, a lot of dumping was happening from China and other Far East markets. So we always expected that there will be some kind of tariff barriers to protect the Indian manufacturers, and it didn't happen. So, you know, we are looking at a period wherein 9 months will be without a duty. BCD has been announced but not yet notified. I think government needs to clear up on the policies. If they have to do 450 gigawatt of renewable energy by 2030, I think we cannot do it based on what is happening, you know, all the dumping which is happening from China. I think if we have to do it, we have to manufacture in India. Some, you know, schemes like PLI scheme, though it's got a little delayed, but, you know, those schemes are very good for the market. I think we need to have polysilicon and wafer ingot manufacturing to come into India. And also policies like, you know, yesterday I was reading that, you know, the GST is going to get increased from 5 to 12%. So, you know, all these becomes a dampener, because when there is there's no clarity on what is going to happen tomorrow in terms of policies, people kind of are unsure on what to do. So they postpone their purchases. They don't know how manufacturers, we don't have the luxuries of high margins. We are anyways working on wafer thin margins. So for us, it becomes very risky, because policies change and we assume some margins which ultimately we lose. So I think that clarity needs to come from the government.
That's very true. And like, if you can just enlighten about the new launch of Satvik. So what's the distribution plan for the new launch you talk about?
So we are very positive on the retail business in India. So we want to get to the last mile to all across the country, and we are heavily focusing on building our sales and distribution team. And you know, we want to reach to the last mile. We want the customer to demand for the product and the panels from their installers. So we want that visibility also to be in the market. And you know, till now it's been more B2B industry, but I think in future it will become more B2C, and customer will become more and more aware. And rooftop in India has a huge potential, and rooftop has just begun. Out of 100 gigawatt, the ratio was 40 gigawatt rooftop and 60 ground mounted. I think ground mounted has done fantastic, but I don't think rooftop has done even 10% of that. So that has a huge potential.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot for being us.
Thank you very much.